Bago mangyari ang pandemya, normal ang takbo ng mundo. Lahat ay nasa kani-kanilang lugar na kinabibilangan hanggang sa.
To my fellow Filipinos, today we face the very grave threat of the novel coronavirus disease 2019 or COVID-19.
Gamit sa Metro Manila fighting to bring down infections.
Parating sa ating mga kumbaya na hindi mo kayo gawin mag-isip ng ating pamahalaan, kailangan magtulong-tulong tayo.
Sinimulan na sa Paranaque ang mass testing para sa COVID-19.
Paranaque has signed an executive order prohibiting the discrimination against COVID-19.
I call on our people to remain calm, vigilant, responsible. Tayo ay mag-isa, together as one nation, this challenge can be overcome.
Ang mga establishmento ay naging sarado. Mga lugar na dati ay matao, naging paralisado. Mga empleyadong nawalan ng trabaho. Mga pamilya wala nang maihain sa plato.
Hi, I'm Carlo Castillo, 27, and I own Otako Food and Beverage House that has 130 plus branches nationwide.
Hi, I'm Miss Arlene Ramirez, the owner of R Essential Spa, Salon, and Facial.
Hi, I'm Jana Bautista, owner of Jana's Party Shop.
The nature of our business is more on selling or providing the Filipinos affordable Japanese snack like takoyaki, ramen, gyoza, and yakisoba. And we plan to expand in the future to become a mini restaurant that can serve different varieties of Japanese food.
Jana's Party Shop is mostly rentals of chairs and tables, events, balloon decors. We offer also catering services.
We are engaging or rendering services to our clients, and we provide a variety of services like for hair, for body, and for nails. For the purpose of improving health, beauty, and relaxation.
When did you start your business and what made you start your business?
I started when I was in college. Bali, parang naging passion ko siya. Yung pag-decor sa mga parties. Kasi sa family namin, madalas may mga parties, ganyan. At tapos hobby ko yung mag-aayos. And then nakita ko na may prospect siya maging, may possibility siya maging business. So yun, doon siya nag-start.
I started Otako way back January 2020. And actually, this is just an accident business for me. Because before, I used to work in the company of my parents. Then by that time, I want to have my own and a breaker for myself. That's why I came to an idea to create this brand, Otako Takoyaki, which we established in Genti de Leon, Valenzuela.
We started this business year 2010. And before kasi, the plan was we are searching for a business na talagang would suit our passion. And then we decided to come up with a salon. Salon. At first, salon muna siya. Then, expand na nag-expand. So, nadagdagan na siya ng spa for body and nails.
How is your business doing before the pandemic hits?
Okay. Before the actually two months before the pandemic, we started the business because we started January 2020 and the pandemic struck at March 2020. So we had 2 months before the pandemic. So we were doing really well, to be honest with you. We were doing really well because the foot traffic was there, the crowd was there, the students was there. But after the pandemic, that's the magic happened because plenty of employed people got interested in doing business.
Kasi the business was very stable when it comes to financial and yung sa market namin, we have a lot of customers na kasi we were established for 11 years na kami. So okay na yung when it comes to our loyal customer.
Before the pandemic, syempre okay kasi 13 years na ako established na siya. So marami na ako nag-gain na customers, clients, may mga tie-up na rin ako. So, okay siya before the pandemic.
So, if it's okay to divulge the information, what is your average gross profit per month?
So, more or less, nasa siya? Kailangan ba? Target kasi namin, 500,000 a month.
A month.
On peak season, 60 to 100, umaabot ako kapag December months kasi nga sunod-sunod ang cater. Pero pagka ordinary days, 40, ganyan.
The average gross profit per month of Otako is 1 million to 1.5 million.
What are the problems and challenges you have encountered in sustaining your business trend during the pandemic?
Challenges during the pandemic? Yun nga, kasi diba, ang pinakaunang naapektuhan ng pandemic is events. Pinakancel nila, hindi daw pwede mag-event. So, ang challenge, talagang hindi kami pinagbukas kung paano ko siya i-continue. Nawala kasi lahat ng, ng clients, natakot, mag-party, ganyan.
Oh, napakarami, sobra. Kasi it's our first time, siyempre, this crisis na to, it's our first time So, ang number one, yung restriction ng government. With the IATF, lahat ng protocols kailangan sundin. So, ang kasi namin, yung spa kasi, hindi siya essential. Not like yung mga restaurant or food. So, hindi siya essential. So, talagang napakahirap siya i-survive in terms of kasi pag nagbigay ka kasi ng services, siyempre may touch ng tao, di ba? Like for example, how would you massage the person if you were not touching the person, di ba? So talagang, and ang pinakamahirap doon, how to convince the customers despite of the virus.
The main problem that we've encountered were the safety protocols because we all know that safety protocols were different in different areas. For example, you are living in Bulacan, you will be given a different protocol. If you're living in Manila, you will be given a different protocol. So it's really hard for us to transport all the ingredients, the equipments that we may need to open the store. But still, with the right connection and the strategy, we were able to do that. We were able to provide letters. We were able to provide certificates that we are, Otako sa food business. So, we are an essential.
So, how do you compare the following areas in business before and during the pandemic? Foot traffic.
Foot traffic before pandemic, okay. Kasi along the highway yung pwesto So, maraming pumupunta, maraming pumapasok. Pero nung nagkaroon ng pandemic, binawal, sarado shop. So, totally, walang pumapasok na client. Mostly, o order lang online, ganyan.
So since I'm engaged in a food business, and Otako is a snack business, it's a snack food business, it's not a staple food, we really need the food traffic. Before the pandemic, the food traffic is very high because, as I've said earlier, there's plenty of students passing by. There are plenty of workers because work from home were not implemented by that time. Unlike this pandemic, we weren't able to get that food traffic because it's very low, because most of the students were studying from home, most of the workers were working from home. But the good thing there is that our sales went higher than the pre-pandemic era, because most of the people tend to eat because they are stuck at home. They are looking for something to do, and they are looking for something to eat. That's why the sales of our stores became higher than the previous, than the pre-pandemic situation.
So, yung before, siyempre, we have a loyal customer na, so they come and go often sa spa para maano nila yung mga services na gusto nila. So, okay lang. Wala problema dun sa customers. Yung they enter the spa, they lahat, maraming ano. So, nung nagkaroon ng pandemic, ang mahirap na i-convince. Ang number one na ano nila, what if kung yung gagawa sa kanila is may ano siya, di ba, may COVID.
Profit and sales.
Profit, bumagsak din siya nung nagka-pandemic. Pero nung before nga, sabi ko nga sa'yo, okay yung mga events kasi lahat na-handle ko. Lahat ng mga klase ng gatherings. Pero nagka-pandemic, nawala, totally bagsak.
For the pandemic, so okay naman yung we are financially stable, masasabi ko. Kasi siguro dahil dumating na kami doon sa 11 years, okay na So, stable naman na lahat. So, during pandemic, wala, doon na nag-start yung
decline.
Yes, the decline. Lahat ng sales and profit. Kasi ano na. So, siyempre, nalasin na yung customer na nagpupunta.
In my case kasi, it's not a valid comparison. Because when we started pre-pandemic, we just new to the business. We really expanded during the height of the pandemic, during the mid 2020, when COVID were rising, the number of outlets of Otako were rising as well, because there's plenty of people interested in investing to us. Well, of course, the quality of the product that we provide and the branding that we carry. So It's not a valid comparison, but if you will ask me that question, I can say that the pre-pandemic, I mean the height of the pandemic was way better than the pre-pandemic, because as I said earlier, people stuck at home, they tend to look for something to eat, they tend to look for something to do, unlike when we were still normal 3 years ago. They have a normal routine. When you were a student, you will go to class, then go home. When you are an employee, you will go to your office, then go back to your home.
How do you compare the following areas in business? Operating hours.
So, in the operating hours, there's very huge difference between pre-pandemic and during pandemic, because during at the height of the pandemic, curfew were strictly implemented. So in some cities, in some areas, their curfew is up until 7 p.m. only. Then some areas in Bulacan and other provinces nearby Metro Manila doesn't allowed by the LGU to operate during the weekend. So the operating hours were totally different, because pre-pandemic you can operate as much as you want. You can handle your own time. While during at the height of the pandemic, you have to follow the protocols, you have to follow the guidelines provided by the local government unit. So in pre-pandemic, it's like you're a free businessman. while during the height of the pandemic, you are a controlled businessman wherein you have to follow the guidelines given to you.
Operating hours, mas matagal ako nung before. 7 to 7. 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. Tapos minsan nag-extend pa kapag may mga catering services na talagang gabi na natatapos. Pero nung pandemic, nagbawas ng oras. So, naging 8 to 5 na lang ako. Tapos, wala na rin yung mga aftershock na parties. Pagka close ng shop, wala na talaga.
Before the pandemic, we are operating 12 hours a day. From 10 a.m. to 10 p.m. During pandemic, it's nag-operate na kami ng 8 to 9 hours a day.
How about human resource, yung mga employees?
So human resource, before we have 35 staff, both Caloocan and Dituason. When the pandemic hit, so na-decline siya, tapos at the same time, but we settled for skeletal force.
Ilan?
So, buo pa rin sila, but they will, parang papasok na lang sila 3 times a week.
Human resources, well, as we all know, during the pandemic, there are plenty of people that were cut in their job. So it gives us an opportunity to hire more and to haggle their salary, of course. So when it comes to human resources, we didn't encounter any scarcity because we always look for someone who really needed that job. So that's our qualification, and also we don't have that much qualifications.
Stocks and inventories.
Stocks. Again, mas marami nung before. Weekly halos nag-i-stock kami bagong items, pero nung during pandemic, ang tagal bago maubos. So mas naging madalang yung pagre-replenish namin ng stocks ng items. Ayun.
Yung before, okay naman kasi we have parang system na nandun yun. Tapos at the same time, yung mga suppliers, bumili ka ng stocks, nandyan yung readily available sa market, nandyan na siya agad. San tawag mo lang, they will deliver na. Pero when the pandemic ulit hit, yung stocks, pag tumatawag pa sa supplier, mahirap na.
During the pandemic, we've really encountered major challenges when it comes to inventory because 50% of our ingredients came from Japan. So since we're using an authentic Japanese ingredients, we had major problems when it comes to transporting them because COVID is an, I think it's an airborne, it's an airborne disease. So it can easily be transported. So the ports doesn't easily accept cargoes from other countries. So they really have to check that well. So we had weeks of delays compared to the previous pandemic, but the solution that we've implemented to counter that problem is we just have to look for multiple suppliers. But of course there's a downside with that because on your usual supplier you get to haggle the price, while if you look for another suppliers and they notice that you really need that specific demand, you cannot haggle your price because you have to operate or you have to continue your operation. That's the downside during the height of the pandemic.
What are the advantages and disadvantages the pandemic has caused your business?
Siguro kasi depende kasi yan doon sa business.
For example, sa essential.
Kasi doon sa business namin, parang kasi it is not essential eh. Diba? Like food. So, ang laki ng impact ng talaga na nangyari dito sa business namin.
Mostly disadvantage. Kasi napasara talaga eh. Ang tagal nagsara nung tapos nung bumalik naman, medyo natakot na rin yung mga tao. So hindi na ganun yung normal na iba. Kaya mostly disadvantage. Sa advantage naman is dahil nagka-pandemic, medyo somehow nakapag-isip tayo ng other way kaysa nga naman i-give up, diba? Yun. Ang naging advantage niya is naging ano tayo, innovative tayo. Nag-isip ako ng way kung paano siya magko-continue pa.
Does your business have an alternative strategic plan for the sudden implementation of community quarantine during the pandemic?
Yes, oo. Bali, nag-switch ako sa online platform. Kasi nawala talaga, kagaya nga sabi ko, nawala yung foot traffic. Hindi na ano. So, ang naging alternative ko is nag-switch ako sa online. Doon ko pinost yung mga mga products. Tapos nag-offer ako ng mga yung mga tutorials para DIY na lang. Para yung mismong client na lang yung gagawa ng mga decors sa nila, sa mga party nila.
We come up with the with this solution. So the only solution na naisip namin is to build a team para to continue our services with the client, na which is a home service. It's home service. So si home service, we provide the transportation, the lahat ng healthy protocols, and yung result ng antigen with our staff, yung pinapakita namin sa mga customers namin.
So given the current economical movement allowed, will you still venture or retain to your strategy or not? And why?
Yes, oo. Kasi sa online, mas dumami market, mas may market. Actually, mostly nga nag-switch na sa online platform . Lahat ng mga dati ko ring clients, through online na lang din sila umorder talaga. So, kahit bumalik pa sa i-retain ko yun. Tapos, pati yung mga alternative products na dinagdag ko, isasama ko pa rin yun kasi additional income pa rin siya kahit papano.
So, may kinonsider ba kayong alternative products and services sa business ninyo nung nagkaroon ng pandemic?
When I started Otaho, we really don't have a backup plan for additional products. So when we started Otaho, we started selling one flavor only of takoyaki. Then when we noticed that the trend of the market is getting slower, getting lighter, that's the time that we added different products such as ramen. Then when we added ramen already, it gives us an idea to expand more on providing quality Japanese snack at affordable price. That's the time that we added gyoza and yakisoba. Now we sell milk tea as well, because as I said earlier, the goal of Otaho is to become a small Japanese restaurant food express. That's why we added that.
Before hindi kami nagsasell ng mga products. So parang nag-venture ako dun sa beauty products. So tapos then inadd ko yun sa mga for example sa Facebook account namin, sa namin yung mga facial product.
So kinonsider mo bang mag-go online, partial online, or mag-go through social media sites during the pandemic?
The time of the pandemic, yes. Actually, 70% of our sales came from online.
Yes,
in what way?
Yes, in terms of, kasi, diba the customer, parang hard sila para makonta kami, kasi minsan open, close, ganun. So yung online na yon, yun yung naging platform namin to contact us. Then, through Facebook account, through they can reserve their services through online.
What are the factors na kinonsider mo when you go through online platforms?
Kasi number one, convenient. Ang online, kapag in-order sa'yo, tapos na-deliver mo, okay na. So, convenience yung number one factor, kaya ako siya Tapos, mas mabilis mo ma-reach yung client, yung customers mo, mas malawak kahit sa ibang lugar yung unlike dati, yung mga client ko from Caloocan lang. Yung online, mas marami silang nare-reach na iba pang client.
Well, there's no foot traffic during the pandemic talaga. So, online is the only solution. And it's free. So, we have to maximize that. Kasi, you don't have to pay online. You just have to post. You just have to promote. So, yung foot traffic namin. Well, nung nag-operate kami nung first wave nung ECQ, nag-try kami mag-open without posting online. It only gave us isang store namin. Ha? Yung isang store namin na yun, before, nag-average siya ng 10,000 to 15,000 a day. Pero nung nag-operate kami during the ECQ ng first wave without posting online, it only gives us, I think, 300 pesos. So there's a huge gap between the sales provided during every pandemic and during at the height of the pandemic. So we came up with an idea to boost our product online. Kasi nung first wave ng ECQ, hindi pa uso yung mapabili. Hindi pa uso yung mga... Hindi pa ganun kalakas si GrabFood noon. Foodpanda wasn't that food... Foodpanda is not the Foodpanda today before that. So, that's our only solution.
So, what are the things na kinonsider mo for this online business to succeed? And what are the risks of doing so?
Consistency. Kasi kailangan consistent ka dun sa ano mo, sa mga products mo, ganyan. Or consistent ka rin sa pagsagot. Kung halimbawa, kasi minsan busy ka eh. Kapag hindi mo nasasagot yung client mo sa ano, ang bilis din nila mag-switch kasi maraming online. Iba pang ano, party needs din. Tapos sa risk naman, third party mostly lagi. Halimbawa, okay, sige, naibigay mo si product mo na maayos, kaso yung sa delivery naman, third party, syempre, i-deliver. Doon, nagkapalpak-palpak o delayed ng delivery. Eh, syempre, ang party may time, di ba? Kailangan ma-deliver mo siya. So, isa yun sa mga risk na kinukonsider ko.
So, nung nag-go through tayo sa online platform, nag-help ba to sa pag-grow ng business mo?
I think, oo, nakatulong kasi siya. Lalo na dun sa Facebook, ano namin, ads. Kasi, siyempre, most of, ano ngayon, most of, kumbaga, the people are venturing or laging, ano sila, updated when it comes to online, di ba? So, social media is very, ano, very effective way of advertising your company.
Ano, nadagdagan talaga profit yung through online kasi mas ano eh mas marami akong na-reach na market. So yung market lumaki online kasi dati yun nga yung walk-in lang o yung mga dating clients ko lang, ngayon mas lumawak siya. Kaya mas malaki rin yung naging profit dahil doon sa online platform na yun.
Why do you think people venture with online purchases and online platforms?
Number one, safety. Kaya nag-online pa rin. Nakasanayan na rin siguro kahit magbalik tayo sa normal. Ano eh, mag-online na lang din kasi sila kasi nga safe. Number two, convenient sa kanila. Diba? Orderin mo lang online, hindi mo na kailangan lumabas. Hindi mo na kailangan umalis ng bahay.
Ano sa tingin mo yung mas prefer na tao? Online or yung physical?
Okay. Well, unang-una muna, bago tayo makapag-provide ng concrete answer dyan sa question na yan, we have first to determine kung anong product yung ibebenta natin. Because some product needs physical store. So, for example, you are a startup clothing business. Physical store is an advantage because the customers get to check your product physically. Pero kung halimbawa, like us, you will sell mostly ngayon yung mga snack online. Yung mga like yung mga frozen ice cream, yung mga bites. Yun, it's an advantage online because you don't have to pay for your staff. You don't have to pay for your rental fee. You don't have to pay for electricity. So meaning the overhead on a daily basis wasn't there if you're gonna sell online. So I think that's the main factor why startup entrepreneur prepare to sell online nowadays due to no overhead on a daily basis.
On the seller's perspective, which is cost efficient for you, online platform selling or the other one?
cost efficient, no? Siyempre, sa online. Kasi once na paano mo na sa kanila, once na deliver mo na, okay na eh. Kapag ka naman kasi yung hindi online, mas marami pang kailangan. Kailangan mo ng tao, kailangan mo ng, siyempre, time, effort, gasoline, transport, ganyan. So, mas cost efficient kapag ka online.
Sa Otawa kasi, it's a mix eh. Kasi we already have a physical store. So, sa amin sa Otako, di ba we have a physical store already? So, since we already have a physical store, we want to maximize our sales by promoting online. So, we are using online as a tool to maximize our sale. Pero we don't just rely online. We also rely on our physical store. So, paano kami magre-rely sa physical store namin? Yan, we give flyers. Our staff were actively getting customers passersby, yung foot traffic ini-involve namin sa operation namin. Kaya dun medyo naging flexible yung business ni Otako kasi we engage on both.
Which will forge stronger profits and establish business stability and flexibility? Is it online or not?
For profit, siguro both. I-retain, kailangan yung online tsaka yung mga walk-in customer. Additional kasi talaga yung online. For flexibility, online, kasi mas flexible yung oras mo eh. Mas, madali lang once na-deliver mo, tapos na. Pero kung sa stability ng business, mas prefer ko talaga yung hands-on ka. Yung i-deliver mo ikaw mismo. Kasi somehow may bonding. Tapos kapag may problem, naaano mo agad, nakokorrect mo agad. Unlike dun sa online, afternoon, wala na.
Actually, ma'am, to tell you honestly, based on our experience, situational yung yung answer to that question. What do you mean by that? If you were situated, halimbawa, sa isang lugar na tulad ng monumento, we all know monumento has very high foot traffic. Physical store will give you more sales than online there, of course. Pero if you are situated in a silent community, pero malawak na community siya, online will give you the boost to your store. So it depends, yes, it depends on the location of the store.
What are your learnings and what advice will you give to other starting businesses?
Ako, I always tell this to other people, to my friends, na try to listen more. Listen more. Kasi we're not always right eh. Even me. Ako, may mga staff ako na I know to myself na I'm not always right. So, try to listen to improve yourself, to improve your performance. Kasi even billionaires listen to their business advisor. So first, that's the first one. You have to listen to better ideas or to someone better than you. Because for me, if hindi ka good listener, you cannot improve that well. Because mataas yung ego mo eh. So, ako from the very start, talagang mahilig ako makinig sa mga business topics, sa mga advices sa akin. Well, to tell you, frankly, just an idea lang. Nung ECQ, hindi pa putok na putok yung mga deliveries nun. Sir, so there's this one friend of mine told me na, bro, subukan mo mag-deliver. So hindi pa talaga putok nun yung mga online pabilis sa Facebook. Wala pa nun. Kasi parang lang siya eh. Parang March, nagkaroon tayong lockdown. April pa lang yun. So nung sinubukan namin yun, imagine yung difference. Yung sales namin ng Monday, 300 pesos. The next day na nagsimula kami magpa-deliver, since nakinig ako dun sa friend ko na nag-advise sa akin, naging 15,000. So ganun kalaki difference. Nag-boost kami online. So since then, dun ko in-apply na talagang we really need to listen to someone na magsasabi sa atin about our business. Pero syempre, hindi pwede kung ano yung sabihin sa atin, paniniwala natin. We have to evaluate. Then second tip ko siguro is, don't be stagnant. yun yung naging problem ko nung 2020, because during 2020 we were opening 2 branches or 2 outlets a week, minsan tatlo pa. So medyo naging stagnant ako when it comes to expanding company-owned store. During that time, nagkaroon kami ng small growth pagdating sa company-owned store or sa profit namin. So that's why we never have to be stagnant. Then pangatlo, save less, invest more. So if you are earning, let's say, 100,000 a day, siguro isave mo lang doon yung 30,000. Then for emergency fund mo yung 20,000. Then half of your earning must be invested somewhere else. Kasi you don't have to work for your money. Let your money work for you. So yun po siya.
Kasi number one, yung para sa akin lagi most of the question ang tinatanong sa akin ng mga ma'am, okay po ba yung spa business, ganyan. Pero ang answer ko lang lagi, kung saan yung passion mo, dun ka. Tapos then pag nahanap mo na yung passion, mahalin mo yung business, mag hands on ka para maging successful, kasi ikaw mismo yung mag-handle mo. And then dapat may short term and long term plan ka. Hindi yung bahala na bukas, walang ganun. Dapat pinagpaplanuhan mo lahat. And you continues to be updated lahat. And hindi nga masama kung you will be globally competitive. Kasi masyado nang malawak ang mundo, marami ng demands ang mga customers. So dapat lagi kang updated. And isa lang din sa natutunan ko dito sa pandemic na to. As a businesswoman, dapat you must be ready with your emergency plan and emergency funds in terms of crisis. Thank you and good luck. Thank you.
Learning. There's one thing I learned during the pandemic talaga is that nothing is certain. Alam mo yun, kahit na kabisado ko na yung ginagalawang kong industriya, nung dumating yung pandemic, wala. Nawindang ako. Nawala. Totally. Lahat ng learnings, ganyan. So, nagulat din ako. Parang hindi ako ready. Kahit na dami ko nang dinaanan na na situation na okay, na-handle ko to, okay, na-handle ko yan. Yun ang hindi ko nakitang, I didn't see it coming. So, kung meron akong may a-advise sa mga mag-startup ng business, it's number one, tiyaga. Magtiyaga lang talaga sila. Na wala kasing madali eh. Lahat ng nag-umpisa mahirap talaga. And hope lang. Kasi during the pandemic, talagang nawalan rin ako ng pag-asa. Sobra. Na parang paano ko ba gagawin to? Number one, affected tong business na to. And so, alam mo yun, hindi ako nawala ng hope na kakayanin, makakabangon uli. Isip lang talaga uli ng way. Tapos, maging innovative ka lang din. Sumabay ka lang sa challenges. Ganyan. We're still in the pandemic pa. Hindi pa siya tapos. So, masasuggest ko, always be ready. Be prepared. Kasi kahit, no matter na anong akala mong okay ka na, hindi pa pala. Meron at meron pa rin palang darating na hindi mo kaya. So, trust ka lang sa process, trust ka lang kay Lord. Pagkatiwalaan mo lang di sarili mo, ganyan, nakakayanin mo yung challenge na yun. Yun lang.
At atin na tunghayan at iba't ibang mukha at istorya ng pagbangon mula sa crisis ng pandemya. Naway maging inspirasyon ito hindi lang sa mga negosyante, kundi sa mga nais magsimula ng panibagong bukas.
Alam niyo guys, ang dami natin natutunan dun sa mga in-interview natin. Parang ang dami nilang experience sa ang dami learnings. Ikaw, Wigo, anong natutunan mo?
Siguro ako yung natutunan ko na lahat pala ng business talaga ng sacrifice ng business. Tapos parang makaisip sila ng mga day nila, kung ano yung parang palagi pa yung business nila kahit ang parang paghirap para talaga magkaroon ng sarili ng business.
Okay. Ako, pinakagusto ko yung learning ko kay Sir Carlo na ano, kahit marami ka na alam, you listen to it. Diba? Kasi meron ka pang matitutunan na hindi ko na ito.
Okay. Ako, mag-a-add lang ako dyan. Kasi be learnable talaga. No? Kasi, you know, kahit marami na tayong alam, may mas better possibility. No? Hindi lang perspective natin yung tinitingnan natin. Siyempre, kuha tayo ideas from other people. So, I believe ka na dapat lahat ng tao may kanya-kanyang mentors. Yung mentors, hindi lang dapat yung age mo or mas matanda sa'yo. Kasi paano naman yung matatanda na, di ba, patay na yung mga mentors. So, in general, dapat meron tayong mga mentors na mas bata sa atin, di ba? Kasi iba yung experience nila. So, yung pinakumatak sa akin, hindi mo tao, di ba? Kaya, okay, dadagdag pa kayo.
Kaya
ako
kay,
Miss
Arlene, sabi
nyo
na parang, you need to have to find your services. Kaya parang makalisip pa siya ng iba dahil nag-grow sila kasi nag-grow sa institutions, tapos ang kasi kailangan tayo ng online, tapos yung service, di ba? Kapagka talaga ng dami nilang discount.
Actually, alam nyo, to sum it up, in general kasi, actually, nalaman ko na talaga kahit nagkaroon ng pandemic, kahit ano pang challenge mo, kakaharapin natin mga Pinoy. Actually, kahit hindi naman siguro, we make it a point na maka-observe tayo sa mga makaka-isip tayo ng
Thank you for today's video.
Thank you.
Bye.
Thanks for watching.